Okay, got another scan tool to check out today, guys. This one's the XTOOL D8 diagnostic scan tool. And like I've said in my previous videos, I'm not much of an unboxer, but I'd like to show you what's in it just so you know what you're getting if you choose to buy one of these for yourself. So let me rearrange here and we'll get into it. Okay, so now that we're into the box, it's just a standard plastic blow mold case. Nothing spectacular, but again, it's nice to have something to put your scan tool in. You've got your manual and a serial number and an activation code. You've got your power brick with a USA plug or a overseas plug. You've got your data cable, and you got your, I guess you'd call this the VCI. It's really just an OBD2 adapter that goes to one end of this data cable. Now I will say first off, the one particular downside to this scan tool that I wasn't crazy about was it does not offer Bluetooth or a wireless connectivity to the vehicle. It's wired only. Now I will say there's some pros and cons to that. The wireless ones seem, or potentially some of them seem to have a bit of a latency or a bit of a delay when populating live data streams or when sending a bidirectional command. And with a wired, you know, scan tool, that latency or that delay is either greatly reduced or not, or gone altogether. So this particular data cable has two different ends. One end goes into the adapter, and then this one would plug into your OBD2 port, and then this end would plug into the top of your scan tool. Anyway, let's get into the scan tool here. So, all right, let me move this case out of the way. This scan tool has a camera on back. It's got your data connection for the cord, a power port, one USB type A port, and a power button. And of course it has the back bracket or back brace, I guess you'd call it, so you can stand it up on a desk, or you can, you know, hang it on your steering wheel or whatnot. Okay, so let's check out the tool itself. This again is called the D8, and I suspect the D8 stands for Diagnostic Scan Tool 8-inch. This is the 8-inch screen. They do make a D7, and which is a 7-inch screen, so that just stands to reason. The other thing, I believe this scan tool was intended to directly compete with the Autel 808. Which is also an 8-inch scan tool. Now I've had an Autel 808, and they make several different versions of that. So don't quote me here, but mine was the MK 808, and it was the Bluetooth version, so it was wireless to the vehicle. But that one didn't have very much for bidirectional control whatsoever. A few special functions, and you know, you could roll the window up and down here and there, but you couldn't cycle evap purge valves or engine fans or fuel pumps or anything like that. Whereas this one here, this tool will do all of that. So in that sense, now, like I said, they make a few 808s in the Autel version, but you know, I can't speak for all of them, but the one that I had specifically, this scan tool is far better than that Autel version that I had. Let me get the cord hooked up here and I'll show you how this thing works. Okay, so I've got the OBD2 connector put on the end of the data cable here, and like I said earlier, this is a corded only tool, and one of the downfalls is the cord that comes with it is not terribly long. I think it's about 5 or 6 feet. So I'll put up a couple pictures here on the screen of some options. You can buy OBD2 extension cables, and that's the key to it. The cable, if you buy just a standard OBD2 cable, if it doesn't say extension cable, it won't work. So what you need is the extension cable, so that one end is female and the other end is male, so it can go between here and your car, and you effectively lengthen, and you put some extra length onto you put extra length onto this cable. Okay, so here we are. So to give you an idea here, we can go to auto scan, and it'll just start scanning. It detected we're in a GM. This thing should auto VIN. I'll have to check. Okay, I'm in a GMC K-Series four-wheel drive. All that's correct. Let's see. I do not have navigation. I have base. Let's see. I have up-level radio, and I have dual zone manual. Click OK. So, auto diagnose. It'll just go in and run a full system, all-module scan. And this particular truck that we're in has a couple little issues. It's got some problems with the stereo system, and it does have a an bad oil pressure sensor. So the oil pressure gauge either reads full 80 or zero, and it's detected that. That's the powertrain one there. But so anyway, this will take a few minutes, and I'm going to speed up the video here so you don't have to watch the whole thing. But this will take, you know, maybe 2 or 3 minutes, 4 minutes to scan the whole vehicle. Depending how many modules your vehicle has, you know, the more that it has, the longer it will take. Okay, so we're back. It finished scanning. And as you can see, I got a couple of little issues with that navigation radio. I don't even have navigation on my radio. And anyway, so that'll give you, and then if you want to go in, like say this top one here is powertrain, you can click on that and then click, you can just click report, and it'll tell you what all the codes are. It'll tell you what module they're in, and it'll give you a quick definition here. So I got some audio outputs and, oil pressure sensor issues. And so that's the quick scan. Yes. And then if we wanted to do diagnostics, you could either manually go in, pick your vehicle, or you just hit the VIN here and then click auto scan. And we're going back into the same vehicle, but it's going to ask those same questions again, I believe. Okay, so yeah, GMC. Okay, we'll do up level, and it's manual. And we go to system diagnose. Actually, those two main buttons, the top one that said auto scan and the bottom one said diagnose, this is the same two here also. So I backed out of the system to go to the diagnose portion of the scan tool, and I didn't have to back out that far. This shows all the different systems in this particular vehicle. You got powertrain, ABS, unit, air conditioning, supplemental restraint. And you can see all the different modules that are in this particular vehicle. And for example, let's go to powertrain. You know, you can go to live data, and this will show all live data in all modules. So we'll go to engine live data. We'll go to, you know, engine live data 2, because there's more than one page worth. And here you'll select which particular PIDs you'd want to look at on live data. So let's just, for example, pick terminal, alternator terminal command, and engine speed, let's just say, and then hit OK. And there's the engine RPM, and the generator terminal signal command is on. We can go to special functions. You get fuel trim reset, fuel composition reset. And that, I want to say one thing here about scan tools in general. And that does, if you're in the market for a scan tool and you're looking for more than just, you know, a code, if you're looking for more than just a code reader, you want a diagnostic scan tool that has a little bit of functionality, you know, bidirectional control. It's not the scan tool that's doing these functions. The computer in the vehicle has to be, like for example, in this truck here we got a fuel composition reset. Well, in this era of GM vehicles, they produce these cars and trucks without an ethanol or alcohol sensor. And the way that it determined how much ethanol was in the gasoline, it kind of calculated it based on fuel tank fill-up events and O2 readings and, you know, drive time and all. It had a formula for calculating alcohol percentage. The problem was they got confused. The computer in the truck got confused. And so in order for GM to fix that, they had to go in and put in the software fuel composition reset. Now, you probably are never going to find this on any other vehicle that didn't have, like, you wouldn't find this on a Ford truck of the same year or on a Honda Accord from the same year. It's the vehicle that dictates what menus populate on the scan tool. So I've had people send me questions or comments under the video saying, hey, can that scan tool do such and such on a, you know, pick a year, make and model? And I say, well, I don't know. You know, I don't have one of those vehicles to plug into. And they'll say, well, can't you just go turn your scanner on and, you know, put in that make and model information? Well, no, I can't, because unless the scan tool is plugged into the vehicle, you can't go into the menus. It can't go past like the first menu, because it's the computer in the car that dictates the menus to populate on the screen of the scan tool. So the scan tool is not running any of these extra special functions, okay? It's the vehicle and the computer that's doing it, and it's just the scan tool that is sending the command. You know, sometimes people might buy a scan tool, they see something on the internet, like, take for example, an ABS auto brake bleed. Well, not every vehicle, every make and model ever manufactured is capable of running an auto bleed. But they'll see a video on the internet of somebody doing it, they'll buy a scan tool, plug it into their car, and then they'll say, well, that scan tool's junk, it doesn't work, it doesn't... Well, it's possible, it might be a faulty scan tool, but more than likely your make and model wasn't programmed for an auto bleed, so therefore the scanner can't send a command to anything. The vehicle wouldn't know what to do with it if it could. So, but now I will say, on the other side of the coin, on the flip side, let me back out of these menus here. If we go to special functions, you know, like this scan tool claims, like, what, 31 special functions. You know, oil or life reset, throttle learn, electronic parking brake, steering angle sensor, you know, instrument cluster, gearbox match. You know, you got all these functions. Well, opposite of what I was just saying, when the scan tools list these special functions, they list them all, right? But we're sitting in a 2006 Chevy pickup. I don't have an electric parking brake, battery reset, or, you know, back when this truck was made, there was no such thing as a battery module. You know, you just put a new battery in and the vehicle ran. So, or like a DPF. Well, that's only for diesels, and I have a gas motor. So, you know, kind of opposite what I was saying before, where it's the vehicle that dictates the menus that populate in a scan tool. Well, when you look at the special functions that they brag about or that they advertise, you know, they list them all, whether your vehicle is capable of it or not. So it's the opposite. So anyway, that was the special functions. Updates over here. This is just if you were on Wi-Fi, any updates. And by the way, this scan tool gets 3 years of free updates. So this is where you'd go on your home Wi-Fi, type in your network name and password, boom, it's on Wi-Fi, and it'll download all the updates, just one touch, and it automatically updates the scan tool by itself. Settings, this is the settings within the diagnostic software. Extended functions here, you got xCloud and Endoscope. Endoscope is just one of those little, like a little camera on the end of a, it's like a little camera on the end of a wire, and it would plug into your USB port here. And xCloud, not really sure what that is, if you can store files on the cloud or whatever. Hit the back button here. Remote control, this is for if you wanted to allow somebody at XTOOL to remote into your scan tool and give you assistance with something, that's where you would do that. Report, this is where you get diagnostic reports and whatnot of all of your previous vehicles that have been hooked to the scan tool. And, of course, I already looked at the special functions, updates, settings. And then, you know, of course, this is just your typical Android scan tool. You know, you can go, like, you can go on, here's your apps right here. You can go on a browser, and you can go to, like, this was going to, I'm not on Wi-Fi right now, but, and, but there's an Adobe Reader, and there's the camera, of course, on the back. And here's the settings for the scan tool itself. The other settings I showed you was for the settings within the diagnostic software. This is the settings for the scan tool, the tablet. And of course, you can even play games on here. Anyhow, you get the point. We'll go back into the diagnosis software. And there you go. This is XTOOL's new diagnostic D8 scan tool. It's pretty slick. It shows all live data on all modules. It has all full bidirectional control on all modules as long as the vehicle is programmed to do it. And you can't do something that the vehicle isn't programmed to do from the factory. And, it's pretty slick. Like I said, the one downfall is that it's a corded device, but there are also some pros to being a corded device. There's less latency and less delay. And like I said, you can get an extension OBD2 cable for between $10 and $15. So check it out. See what you think. And just one more thing about scan tools. I want to finish off by saying there's no perfect scan tool. There are glitches with all of them. You may find on any brand that you buy that your vehicle should have a special function or should have a full bidirectional control that should be functional on your vehicle, and a particular scan tool just won't send the command. That is possible. Those glitches exist in all brands of scan tools. It doesn't matter where you buy them, whether it be an import brand or a high-end tool truck brand. You know, you could spend $5,000 or $8,000 on a brand name tool truck USA scan tool and still have problems not being able to send certain commands or be able to read certain things. So with everything I just said about the vehicle's computer populates the menus, that is true, but every brand has its own little glitches here and there. There's several famous YouTube mechanics that have, you know, decades of diagnostic experience, and most of those guys that do this every single day for a living with decades of experience, you know, they might own 5, 6, 7, 8 scan tools. You know, certain scan tools work better with certain brands of makes and models of vehicles. There is no perfect scan tool. I know I'm not going to name names, but I know of a specific guy that I'm thinking of. He's got every brand of scan tool you can think of. And the most expensive scan tool he owns is the one that he uses the least because he's very frustrated with it. The thing doesn't do half the stuff that it's supposed to. So if you do buy a scan tool and there's a couple glitches you find within the software, about the best thing you can do is send that particular manufacturer an email, let them know of the glitch that you've stumbled upon. And I know XTOOL specifically, I've ran into a couple little glitches. I sent them an email, and within a couple of days, they had sent out an update, an over-the-air update, and I updated my scanner, and everything worked just fine. So if you do buy a scan tool and for a specific function, and all of a sudden you're having trouble with it, just send the manufacturer an email, and they should be able to send out a software patch to fix that for you. So, all right, done talking about that. Anyway, that'll do it for now. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.